Thus, not long ago, a novelist made the following statement in a magazine speaking of followers of Jesus. Here is how their ignorant bigotry works. First, they put the fear of God into you. If you don't believe the literal word of the Bible, you'll burn in hell. Of course, the literal word of the Bible is tremendously contradictory, and so you have to abdicate all critical thinking and accept a simple system of belief that it's dangerous to question. You understand that Satan resides in the toils and snares of complex thought, so it's best not to try to think at all. Now, it is in the midst of that context that I and my colleagues are calling the church to rededicate herself to a vibrant life of the mind and to re-engage the culture non-defensively and in a non-angry kind of way, in a civil kind way, but in a rigorous and thoughtful sort of way. It is a ministry of giving reasons to believe in Christianity and responding to objections raised against it. It is a way to care for souls. I want you to turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 10. And beginning in verse 3, it says the following: though we walk in the flesh, that means as human beings, we do not war according to the flesh. Verse 4, the weapons of our warfare aren't like that. That's not how we fight warfare. Instead, our weapons are divinely powerful for the destruction of what? Fortresses. Fortresses. So in this kind of warfare, we target fortresses. That raises the question, what is a fortress? And the simple answer is, a fortress is an idea or a theory of some kind that undermines the knowledge of God.
Enemy-occupied territory, that is what this world is. Christianity is the story of how the rightful king has landed. You might say landed in disguise. And is calling us all to take part in a great campaign of sabotage.